this is where I hang out at most of the time, you know, before my wife, when my wife was here, this is where I used to be.
I try to stay in my own zone, you know, but it seems like wherever I go, somebody always know, though, that I'm one of the Fort Heights Four.
The Fort Heights Four were four young men who were convicted of the 1978 double murders of a young couple in Fort Heights. Two of them were sentenced to death, Dennis Williams and Vernil Jimerson, and two were sentenced to life in prison, Willie Range and Kenny Adams. In 1996, they were exonerated and released from prison.
Yes!
I'm free. I mean, finally, I'm officially free.
I am sorry to these defendants personally and on behalf of the criminal justice system.
Three other men eventually were convicted as the real killers. And in 1999, they received what was then a record legal settlement, $36 million from the county.
No, it's the honeycomb hideout. The man cave is the camper out there. It's called a man cave.
What do you have a fear of?
Going to jail. I don't want to go to jail. I come right here in my little man cage. That's why I went and bought this thing, so I have a place to come in with my own little sanctuary. When I'm driving, the police get behind me, I get real nervous. That's, I guess you can call it a phobia of some type, I don't know.
Dennis Williams died in 2003 from a heart attack. Kenny Adams, by his attorney's account, is doing very well, lives a very quiet life down in Flossmoor. Willie Range lives in Northwest Indiana on a ranch, about 12 acres, and just sort of noodles around his ranch all day.
Even with all these trees, it gets hot?
Oh, yeah.
Does the fact that you were in prison for all that time for something you didn't do, does that still weigh on you? Is that still...
Sometimes. Mm-hmm. I think about it. Yeah, I drink every day. I'm what you call a bona fide, certified legal alcoholic. You'll never see me staggering drunk, though. Mm-hmm. Never, ever will you see me like that.
Yeah, it'll be 62 this year. Huh? This year. Oh, okay.
Oh, in August you'll be 62.
Vernil Jimerson has pretty much spent his money on a variety of things, you know, some on houses and cars and some on drugs by his own account.
So did you think you had it made with all that money, or did you think that was going to always last? Or
I thought it would, but it didn't, you know. After the bills started hitting me, you know, Dr. Bill hitting most of it, you know, most of my money went to them doctors and everything. Mm-hmm. I get disability every month.
How much is that?
$720. Yeah. I pay bills and everything, you know.
So you get $700 or so a month?
Yeah.
And that's all you're living on?
Yeah, that's all I'm living on now.
Is there anything left from your settlement, or it's all gone?
No, it's all gone. After I got out, you know, jail, you know, I started using crack cocaine and everything, you know. I'm trying to ease my mind and everything on that.
What were you trying to ease your mind about?
About just ease my mind, you know. At that time, I was still hearing the bars, you know, and the joint closed in my head and everything.
Did you ever go back to prison?
No. Oh, yeah, I did. On the drug case, I had a couple of drug cases. So I went back. They gave me a year. I did 61 days.
But you've been clean since?
I've been clean since.
What they all share was this experience of the anger still sort of trailing after them, that while it may recede, it doesn't disappear entirely. They still can get angry over it. They don't think about it as much, but when they do, it still angers them.
When you got out, were you angry at the people, you know, the prosecutors and the police?
They asked me that, and I walked away from that interview. I refuse to answer that. What y'all say? I plead the fifth.
Did the settlement, you know, the money that you received, make everything right?
No. I was born without money. I'm going to die without money. Like I tell my wife, if it's about the money, take it all. Just leave me enough to live, because I'm finna be 57. The way the system got me set up, 21 years, I'm supposed to be dead anyway.